What is up, guys? I haven't been on YouTube in so long. I've just been out the way. I've just been trying to get barber school done with. But hey, I'm here back with another tutorial. This is going to be a tutorial on braids. I call them the Travis Scott braids, you know. And I had one of my friends, her name's Scotty. She does braids. She does a really cool job. If you guys want to hit her up, man, that'd be dope. Yeah, she gets down on braids, man. That's all I gotta say. She used to braid my hair when I used to have long hair, and you know, I had asked her, I'm like, hey, can you braid up one of my clients? It'd be a dope collab video. Came through, and this is the result. Dang, like, look at those braids, bro. Like, how do you get them to be that perfectly split apart? All right, here she's putting, I think she said it's foam to help lay down the stranglers. So that's what she was doing. And later on, you'll see she pulls out a silk do-rag and she just throws it on there just to make sure that, you know, by the time we dry off his hair and all that, it's ready for the haircut so that I'm not cutting through all this foam and stuff. Now, this is where I jump in. So I start off with my Slimline Pro LIs, and I like to begin my guideline right at the temple where the hair goes into the C cup, because this fade is a mid fade, a mid high fade, as I would like to call it. Every barber has different preference, man. That's all I gotta say is, to me, this might be a mid fade. To someone else, it might be a high fade. But watching YouTube videos, you'll learn and see how different barbers are and what they consider different haircuts. And I'm gonna take this tutorial real slow for you guys, man, because I want you guys to be able to see this step by step. Next, I go with my magic clips, and I'm over here brushing away the hairs. I'm making sure that my canvas is clean. And I'm gonna start my guideline about an inch, probably like 3/4 of an inch, with the lever open. And by doing this, I'm allowing myself to have more room for error. And a lot of beginners, you know, as beginners, you tend to make, you know, and myself too, when I was a beginner, I tended to make my guidelines really, really small. Well, that didn't give me room for error. So making it bigger, and right here, I'm gonna go back with it closed and get back at that line. Making your guidelines bigger gives you more room for error. So let's say that me having it closed, I go up a little bit higher. Well, maybe I might go up a little bit too high. Well, if you do your guidelines small, you're gonna get rid of that whole guideline. So by making it big, you're over here giving yourself more room for error, and you're able to go up a little bit higher if you'd like. My next guideline is gonna be me opening the lever a little bit more. And I'm just gonna get back at that same guideline, you know, making my way up slowly. I'm not making exaggerated flicks. I'm taking it very slow. I'm making sure that I'm hitting that area that I wanna hit. And just, you know, making sure that I'm not going above the guideline that I actually need to hit. A lot of barbers tend to, you know, oh, they wanna make it look fancy. They wanna make their flick look nice. Don't worry about that yet. The flick will come naturally. I just want you to be able to get your basic, knocking out that guideline that you want to get out. And last but not least, I open up the lever all the way, and I'm making my way all the way back up where I had set that guideline. This is something that I had learned from someone called E. Jones TV. I used to watch him when I was first starting out. And it's something that he called lever play. Now, what that is basically you're going back and forth with what you've messed up or what you notice, dark spot. My next guideline is gonna be with the one guard open, and I'm gonna go same size, 3/4 of an inch to an inch up. And with this, I'm feathering it out, I'm flicking it out. I'm trying to not dig in too deep to that bulk that you can see on top of it, because my tendency when I was first starting out was that I would press too hard and I'd go too high up, and it'd make my fade not look very transitional. It looked like the same number. So I like to just feather it out. And like how I said before, guys, I just want you guys to take it slow. I don't want you guys to be rushing through a haircut. Don't worry about if you take an hour, hour and a half on a haircut right now. You will get there. Just get your fundamentals down and you'll be good. Next, I go with my half guard and I'm going to go closed. And I'm going to barely just get at that bottom line again, just making sure that I'm getting it out. I guess I didn't have a recording of me opening the half guard, but you just open the half guard and go back up to the same position where that one was set at. My next guideline is going to be set with the 1.5 guard, and I'm going to go up to the highest part of the temple, open, and I'm going to just make sure that I make it all even throughout the head. With this kind of hairstyle, I will admit it is hard to be able to get under the braids and to be able to evenly cut it down. But with that, it just comes with, you know, just going slow, slow strokes, making sure that you're going all the way through, all the way up, and you'll be good. Next, I go with my 1 open, and I will go back at that line that was just created with the 1.5 guard and just feather it out like how I did the first time. And don't mind me going back and forth between my half and my 1 guard. That's just me being OCD and making sure that, hey, if I do notice something, I want to take it out and make it as nice as possible. At the end of the day, you have to think that these clients that walk out of your chair walk into the public, and people will ask them where they get their haircuts, good or bad. So you're representing yourself. So that's why I like to just be OCD with my haircuts. Another thing is with the shaver, see how I went up and down? Well, when I went up and down, what I was meaning by that was, see how I'm flicking down now? That's the easiest way to be able to get the bottom line out. That is the easiest way that I can tell you. Going back up will make it extra bald, but flicking it down and just tapping at it will be the best way to get that bottom line out. And I cannot express that enough. Now, coming back around the back, as you can see, I only did one side to be able to show you guys how to do one side and do the 3 sections of the head, because that is honestly the easiest way to do it as a starter. If you go all the way around the head, you're just going to be confusing yourself. At least that's how it was for me. It might work out for you, but it just wasn't my way of learning. So I'm basically doing the same steps I had done earlier and just implementing them in the back.
Thank you.
I'm sorry if you guys wanted to see this side, but I just felt that there was no need to slow it down and do step by step on this side, because essentially it's the same thing that's applied to this side that was applied to the other side. So yeah, I'm just basically doing the same steps over and over, making sure that I get that bottom line out, because that bottom guideline is what builds your fade. So I make sure that I take my time on that, and I make sure that that is the neatest part of the haircut. Coming around to hairlines, man, every time I start a hairline, I start from the middle. And I make sure that I'm starting from the middle, because essentially you're just going to branch out from the middle to the left side and then back to the middle to the right side. And that's how you get it as even as possible. If you go one side and finish one corner, hey, you might have brought that corner up a little bit. So the best way is just to go from the middle, branch out, and then back to the middle and branch out again. And also another thing that I will say is that no one's hairline is perfect, okay? Maybe, hey, you might run into a client that has that perfect hairline, 1 out of 100 people. And this is coming from me. I've been cutting for 3 years, man. I've only run into a couple of those clients. So you just gotta make work with what you got. If you're beating yourself up about, man, this client's hairline is not crispy, it's not as crispy as it can be, hey, that's good, because you're trying to push yourself to be the best barber you can be. But sometimes you have to just take that step back and realize, hey, this client doesn't have a full hairline. I gotta work with what I got.
Thank you.
And another thing I forgot to add is that I use hair dye to be able to make the client's hairline look a little bit more fuller, more dark. It makes the haircut pop out more. It just, you know, and for clients that feel kind of like insecure about their hairlines, this is the perfect thing because you can dab a little bit on and just, you know, make their hairline pop out. That's the finished result right there, man. You know, we got Travis Scott in the building. But thanks y'all for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the haircut tutorial. Hopefully you guys picked up something from it. You know, if you learned one thing from this video, give it a thumbs up. I'd appreciate it. Have a good day.